Day one of the ILA Berlin Airshow kicked off in upbeat mood, with plenty of aircraft, announcements galore, and visitors enjoying the atmosphere.
I think it's great. It's going to be a good show.
Networking is our first hope that will work.
I'm looking forward to the show, especially for the A380.
And she wasn't the only person interested in the Super Jumbo. The show's biggest attraction received an important visitor. German Economics Minister Michael Gloss leading an official delegation around the site. Airbus is confident the world's largest airliner will hit its December delivery deadline to Singapore Airlines, despite concerns the program is slipping further behind schedule.
We've completed the flight testing proper with the two development aircraft. Now we are focusing on the cabin. We've passed with 100% success the evacuation test with MSN7. We have just done the virtual cabin first flight with MSN2, testing all the cabin systems basically on the ground. And we will perform in the near future the early long flights with Airbus personnel, testing all the cabin systems in real long flight situations. And we are filling out the certification dossier now.
The baby of the Airbus stable, the A318, is also making the news, having recently completed its first steep approach landing into London City Airport.
It has a fairly short and narrow runway, and also because of both the obstacles around and for noise considerations, it has quite a steep approach. It has a 5.5 degree slope approach as opposed to the normal, which would be 3 degrees, so it's nearly twice the slope of a normal approach.
Airbus does face challenges. Boeing is racing ahead with orders for its highly efficient twin, the 787. Airbus, meanwhile, is admitting that it's going to have to make serious design changes for its competitor, the A350.
Details of those changes will have to wait. At a news conference today, Noel Forjar, boss of Airbus parent EADS, said a decision on the future of the A350 would be based on customer feedback and made before the Farnborough Airshow in July.
Clearly, Airbus dominated the news here today, also signing a landmark deal with the Russians to convert A320s into freighters. Yet other exhibitors also made the headlines, with Grob rolling out its SPN utility jet in front of its home crowd for the first time, and T-Lert launching a new diesel engine. Tomorrow on Flight TV, we'll be looking at what the defence industry in Europe is unveiling. Join me then.